subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
It's been exactly 4 years since the assembly elections in Uttar Pradesh began in 2017 on the 11th of February. And in the last 4 years, the big political story coming out of Uttar Pradesh has not been Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, but the failure of opposition parties and opposition leaders, from Akhilesh Yadav's Samajwadi Party to Mayawati's Bahujan Samaj Party, Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Gandhi Vadra's Congress, and even Ajit Singh's Rashtriya Lok Dal. If you look at the 2017 elections, you realize what a sweep it was for the BJP, winning 312 of the 403 seats. Well, of course, that might have been a mandate entirely for Prime Minister Narendra Modi and at that point. But since then, the opposition has had enough and more chances to redeem themselves and to be able to repair what had gone wrong with them after the rout in 2017. But it seems that all the opposition parties have remained exactly where they were after the loss, not managing to take even one step further, looking as directionless, as lost, as lacking in imagination as they have all through the last 4 years. In fact, Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath's governance record has been shaky. He's given a fair bit of opportunities to the opposition to counter him, to corner him, and to use that to rebuild themselves. But the opposition seems to have just dodged all these chances, sinking into deeper political wilderness. Let's talk a little bit about the Yogi years. What has his governance record been like? Well, in 2017, after the BJP won the elections, Yogi Adityanath was a surprise pick. As I said, that mandate was for Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and also, of course, there was some clever math that went behind the kind of win BJP managed. Yogi Adityanath had a chance to work on a clean slate, you know, and to write a script for himself which would include a stellar governance record of Vikas, of welfare, of Sushasan, something that the BJP under Narendra Modi claims to stand for. Instead, what we got from Yogi Adityanath, the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, was a very divisive, very polarized, high-handed approach to governance, where the high points have been divisive laws like the anti-conversion law that his government has brought in. So in that sense, if you look at Yogi Adityanath's tenure, there is not much that stands out in terms of infrastructure creation, in terms of big tangible projects. There's nothing he has to show for himself. Unlike his predecessors, both Mayawati and Akhilesh Yadav, who did create these expressways, these parks, which became a symbol of what they did during their tenure. Yogi Adityanath, on the other hand, perhaps the biggest achievement is the anti-conversion law, which helps the BJP keep in check what it calls love jihad. The anti-cow slaughter law is another such achievement of the Yogi government. So in that sense, with his saffron robe, with his divisive polarizing speeches, with his aggressive Hindutva approach, Yogi Adityanath may be a dream chief minister for the BJP. In fact, as our political editor D.K. Singh has argued correctly in an earlier column, a lot of other BJP chief ministers are borrowing from the Yogi playbook. But the one thing Yogi Adityanath has had missing is Vikas, which has been BJP chief minister's key ingredient, besides, of course, the kind of politics that the BJP believes in practicing. In that sense, it's been a lackluster tenure. There is enough ammunition that Yogi Adityanath has given to the opposition, including a very, very checkered record as far as law and order is concerned. The law enforcement under this government in Uttar Pradesh has been a big question, particularly as far as women's safety is concerned. So there was enough and more the opposition could have used to corner the government, to corner Yogi Adityanath. He was not a stellar CM, he was not a difficult opponent in terms of the kind of achievements by any measure, and yet the opposition has failed on that front. So that is the real story of Uttar Pradesh, about how Akhilesh Yadav has remained silent, has largely been either not seen or seen in a very, very underwhelming fashion. Mayawati has seemed more baffled than in control. And of course, Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Gandhi have not managed to make the Congress recover at all from the kind of rout it had faced. In fact, Priyanka Gandhi Vadra's formal entry into politics as in charge of East UP was seen as, you know, a great opportunity for the party to revive itself, but none of that seems to have happened. The opposition parties don't seem to be speaking up on too many issues. They, you know, have been busy making alliances among themselves and then breaking them off, whether it was Congress and Samajwadi Party or Samajwadi Party and Bahujan Samaj Party. So none of these alliances have worked out either. You know, they talk on low-hanging fruits like the Hathras gang rape and murder, but they don't talk about difficult, tricky issues like the Babri Masjid verdict. Moreover, even someone like Ajit Singh, who is a tall Jat leader from West UP, has remained largely silent even during the ongoing farmers' protests, which really should have been right up his alley, but he's made just a few statements here and there, making no real impact. So two former chief ministers, a former Congress president, none of them have managed to make any impact in Uttar Pradesh in the last 4 years. You know, I know the most newsy, perhaps the most attractive political narrative that has come out of Uttar Pradesh in the last 4 years, in terms of just the kind of headlines it makes, is Yogi Adityanath, his rule, whether you like the way he's ruled Uttar Pradesh or you don't like the way he's ruled Uttar Pradesh. But the real story lies in the ineptness of the opposition parties. And with just 1 year to go for the next election, just 1 year left, and a lot of hard work to do if they really want to redeem themselves. For more, log on to our website, theprint.in, to read my column, Politrix.